Hey everyone, welcome to round one. We have won the roll, so we're gonna go ahead and play first. And this pack, this hand is fine. We've got some stuff, we have a three drop, so we're not gonna mulligan. We even have Fade into Antiquity, which hopefully is good, because it's one of our cheaper removal spells. And so it looks like we're playing against Plains and aggro white deck, which means his Nessian Courser is probably... Ooh, geez, look at that. Well, here we go. Off to the races! We don't have anything to do now, but next turn will be filled with action with a Nessian Courser. And if we want to stop this dude, we can play Fade into Antiquity. But I think it would be better to... Ooh, that is nasty. Well, I think we're going to go ahead and curve out with Centaurs. Mono Centaur Control. Phalanx Leader is going to get destroyed by Sip of Hemlock, I can only imagine. Because this guy is pretty good. It's one of the best cards in the set. And he is very scary with Heroic. I don't really want to block very often, but when you've got this guy, who knows what can happen. So this feels sort of dangerous. It feels like we have a Battlewise Valor, so I'm not going to block just yet. I'm going to wait until next turn when I play Nainaina's Disciple. Ooh! And there it is. Jeez, I just have the sickest of reads. Now him playing it, let's see. He put a card on top of his deck, so he doesn't have a land. Which means I'm going to go ahead and just play this Nylea's Disciple and hold back. Because I want to stall out the game for a little bit, I want him to play more creatures. And then we can get rid of the Phalanx Leader. And he's got a Laguna Band Elder, gaining some life by virtue of having the idol on. And here I think I just want to play this Gray Merchant because it motes the Elder. Actually, now let's see. I think I want to play this Return Centaur because it's going to give us more value from by having on the battlefield when we Gray Merchant. And if I were to leave up a trick, I want to represent the... there's one for black, so we're going to go ahead and mill ourselves. Boom! And we have a... Keepsake Gorgon and another Gray Merchant. So any returned... Any raised deads we draw are going to get back some nice creatures. For now, I think we're just going to have to wait. And depending on what he does, we'll end up trading Nylea's Disciple because... it's one of the creatures that we want to return the most. And I'm not going to block his Elder with just this, I think, depending on what he does. Yeah, sure, he's got some stuff. So now we can potentially attack. What happens if we attack? Well, doesn't seem like anything interesting. We can... He'll just end up double blocking, I would say. And that is not very favorable. So we're gonna go ahead and play this Harpy and then ship the turn. I think we have more of a long game just because we have a very high average casting cost and we're playing green with stuff like Nemesis Mortals, whereas he has green-white. I mean, he does have the Phalanx Leader, which is pretty scary. Okay, I'm gonna kill this if possible. So let's go ahead and go to combat. This is probably going to tap our flyer, depending on how aggro he wants to get. He may have a bestow creature. Ah, he's tapping our centaur. Well, let's get in there. Boom. Now we're going to Sip of Hemlock his leader, because I don't really want him to trigger Heroic with this many creatures out. It's going to be scary. Now you can tap down our guy and attack with a bunch of stuff. But then we can also always play the Gray Merchant, and we'll take a bunch of damage. And this scholar isn't really scary at the moment just because he's doesn't really have as much land to play around with. So he can use this, but at the cost of developing his board, which personally I would not do. But without knowing his hand, that may be the better play. He just may not be able to do anything or profitable and just end up using this guy to drain us. All right, so he's gonna get in there, it seems like. Maybe attacking with the Band Elder. I do not imagine he'll be attacking with the Scholar, because that is moting our team for a little bit. And I only think that he's gonna be attacking with this guy. And I'll happily trade there, I think. Just because the Scholar is not really doing too much. The Scholar is making it so that attacking on the ground is not very profitable at the moment. All right, so we're off to attacking. Wow, that's very aggressive. So what can this mean? It means he, let's see. Whenever you cast a spell, he drains. Okay, so what can we do? I think I'm gonna force him to use something, and he can. He might have the +2/+0 and regenerate for a black mana. He might have a Battlewise Valor. At this point, I don't want to block the Band Elder, just because I would prefer to force him to use this trick, and then we can attack a little bit differently next turn. In Gray Merchant, drain him for 4. It's gonna be a little bit of a swing. So if he has another Battlewise Valor, I don't want to block a 2 toughness creature, which means blocking the Tormented Hero is going to be the play. You might have there are a few other tricks, like the +1/+0 and lifelink. There is God's Willing, which is pretty bad. There's the +2/+2 to 2 target creatures. I'm just not really familiar with all of the names right now. Plus we have Fade into Antiquity, which makes leaving this on the battlefield a little bit more profitable for us. So I'm going to go with blocking the hero. Boom. Taste it. What do you have? Dun, 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 dun. We have 6 damage on us. And I hope that he doesn't have too much in his hand to do. Because, well, he has to have something. It's a +1/+0 in lifelink, it seems like. Yep. So he's going to lifelink his elder. And gain a bunch of life, gaining 9, it seems like. And that's fine. So what we're gonna do now is we can attack with the Harpy and the Disciple, leaving the Centaur back, because that will make it, we're gonna play the Gray Merchant this turn. And we'll be able to gain 4. Yummy. And by leaving 2 guys back, he won't be able to attack very well. He could attack with 3 guys, so he's basically trading his elder for 3 more life. And that doesn't seem like it's that great. And it seems like he's out of gas for the most part. He does have the Scholar, which couldn't get pretty bad. But drawing this Mender is going to be pretty excellent for us, because it's going to get back our Keepsake Gorgon, which is going to blow up this guy or this guy. Probably the Scholar at this point. And I can only imagine that he's going to tap down our Harpy here. And so that's fine. We'll go ahead and play our land and play our Scholar, get back our Gorgon, so we can potentially have 8 mana to destroy something next turn with Fade into Antiquity. And there it goes. So we're not going to bother attacking. And let's get this bad boy onto the battlefield. Boom, look at that. Okay, we can also get Gray Merchant. But I would prefer to get rid of the Scholar, and the Gorgon is going to make it so that we can actually start attacking with it. And it's also better if he plays some sort of creature that we want to deal with, whereas Gray Merchant won't. And Gray Merchant was just going to be a drain for 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Yuck. There we go. Drain for life. I think we're high enough life total to where the dealing with a Scholar with the Gorgon is not going to be slow. Too slow. And we've got a Grey Merchant. Not as impressive as our Grey Merchant. I think I would have rather to just hold that down. Ooh, a Voyaging Satyr. That's going to be pretty sweet. So let's go ahead and hopefully attack with our Harpy. Ding, 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 ding. Please don't do that. Please don't tap our Harpy. Please don't tap our Harpy. And we can always trade this guy off. But I'd rather keep him in play just as a blocker. So we're going to go ahead and cast our little Duder. Cast our other little Duder. It would have been better probably to just hold this guy in the to make a curving out with spells better. This really didn't add too much value. He played it when he was on 5 lands, so he effectively used 2 mana to drain for an additional life that he would have been missing with this guy. And that could end up mattering, but it could also be a lot worse. Ooh, March of the Return. Is that good? So I think I'm going to do is I'm going to start crashing. We can crash with the Mender, the Gorgon, but I think we're going to do that. Ooh, and he just lets us attack. Well, that's certainly something. I wonder if he has... Divine Verdict. That makes this turn bad, because if he blocks in the fashion that makes us want to use the Gorgon, then that ends up being a little bit worse. So I think I just want to attack with the Harpy here, and then hold back some other guys, because he does have the Warden, so he could potentially attack. So I'm just going to go ahead and hit with this guy for now. We could also hit with this guy, and he taps down 2 guys, 1, 2, so we have 3 blockers. So yeah, I'm just going to attack with this guy, since I think, given that we have a March, it's going to be, and Keepsake Gorgon, it's going to be difficult to lose a longer game, whereas attacking incorrectly will put us a little bit on our back feet. So I'm going to go ahead and set a stop for his upkeep if he doesn't do anything. And if he does do something, all right, so he's going to drain us. So we're going to go ahead and just use the monstrosity on the Gorgon now. Ruh! Kill this scholar. Boom. Down it goes. All right. And if we can march our Grey Merchant back, then we should be pretty good. Ideally, we can make a play so that our second creature return is going to be useful. So we can throw our Grey Merchant or our Mender in front of something like the Band Elder. Now if he wants to attack, he can't really attack too well because he's without playing a spell, because he can tap down something. Probably our Disciple, but he doesn't really have too many attacks. And we're putting a Baleful Eidolon on our Grey Merchant. Sure, that's fine. I don't mind that. So now we can trade this off. I don't really want to take any damage. So assuming we play March next turn, I think we can trade that off for the Mender and the Satyr. And then we can play return, or we can march the returned some of our guys back. Alternatively, I think I want to go with those. And there we go. Now we can march back. Do we have any forecasting cost guys? Nope. I guess we can go to attacks. It's probably going to tap some stuff down. So we can get Grey Merchant and then the Mender. And the Mender will get back a creature that we trade for the Eidolon. And we still have this, which we can use on the Eidolon. Alright, so he's not going to be doing anything. So we'll go ahead and just pass back and bring back our two guys. Still want to hold this, I think. Just because he doesn't have... He hasn't played anything that's terribly interesting to kill. I mean, there is the Eidolon, but I don't mind trading for one of our dorks. Alright, he played a swamp, and let's see what he's going to combat. Alright, we are blocking nothing. Alright, and so we're going to go ahead and play this Grey Merchant before anything else, I think. Or we can play the Farika's Mender, but I would rather hold that in my hand for a little bit. So we're going to go play this and see if he does anything. Boom. Drain for a lot. And we're going to go to combat and attack with some stuff, I guess. We're in a little bit of a better position, so we'll attack with that, attack with that. And then it should be good. If he wants to chump this guy, I'm more than happy. He's got one card in his hand, might be Divine Verdict. Boom, Divine Verdict. Look at that. Taste it. All right, so assuming he taps down some stuff and attacks with a bunch of creatures, I don't really care too much for using this Fade into Antiquity just yet. Just, it seems like we can trade off some of our cards to make that not too much of an issue. And the Eidolon can... Just go into play his land. Okay, so we're going to go ahead and play this guy next turn. So let's go to attack. Yes. Tapping that. So if we attack with our Grey Merchant, we can go drain for 2, 4, 5, 6, 7. So I think we're just going to wait on that. So let's see. He can block with... If we attack with both Grey Merchants, he can... block here and block with those two. I don't really like that. We can attack with this guy. I actually like that a little bit. So I mean there's the option of attacking with both of these, but yep, and there it goes. Alright, so now I think we're just going to go ahead and play this guy. And then, I mean, we could play the Mender, but that's pretty low value, so I'll wait for one more turn. I mean, we could have just played... We'll play it next turn. Because we can attack with most things at that point. The Grey Merchants are becoming close to unblockable just because they're going to take a lot of his life when we get it back. Ooh, there's a Baleful Eidolon. So we'll go ahead and... I think we'll just go ahead and not bother blocking this one at all. Going to give him a little bit of life back, and then we can do a bunch of tricky stuff on our turn. So we'll go ahead and see if we want to attack. It's going to tap our Gorgon. And so we can attack with quite a few things. We'll attack with our Raptor, and... I guess these two, and we can tap. Yeah, we can attack with these two also. So he's taking four, and we're going to go ahead and play this on his Eidolon. Exiled. Boom. And then ship the turn. And at the end of the turn, we can Lash of the Whip this guy or this guy. Probably going to get rid of the Warden just because it's going to make attacking a lot better. So yeah, this guy's got a few Eidolons. He's got the Divine Verdict, Grey Merchant, Battlewise Valor. So this Phalanx Leader is going to be pretty scary. And there's an Ordeal, sure. Put a plus one counter, so that's not that bad. We can always just hold back the Gorgon. Yeah. So we're going to go ahead and kill that guy. Boom. Look at that. Crack that whip. And let's go ahead and attack. One, two, three, four. He's taking six. And now I suppose we can just get back the Blood Toll Harpy if we really want to. And that's going to give basically make our next turn lethal. Or we can get back the Disciple. I think I'd rather go for the Disciple. Just because it's going to give us a... We have enough creatures on the battlefield that it's going to be the same thing. And there we go. Yes, victory. So, going to sideboard. We have a Dark Betrayal. And let's see. Maybe Viper's Kiss. Maybe Flamecast Wheel. Let's take a look at the cards that we should not play. He has a few Bestow guys, so the Fade and the Artisan Star are probably good enough. Bad cards include... there's not too much bad stuff that I actually want to take out. So we should basically just fit in the Dark Betrayal, which means we can probably take out a mediocre creature, which is... or we can take out a Savage Surge. We can go with the Savage Surge. Since he has a Divine Verdict, he's got a few Eidolons, the Death Touch Eidolons, that don't really trade too well on our side because of that. Whereas Dark Betrayal is going to be pretty sweet against those. So we'll go ahead and make that switch. We could also splash blue for the Singer. That's definitely something. We could bring in those two. He had a lot of low toughness creatures. That would be a little suspect, though. And we could take out the Nylea's Disciple at that point. And that's pretty close. I don't think I want to do that just because his deck is pretty fast and I want to make sure I don't stumble on lands. So we'll go ahead and just submit that.